मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स,
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
मॉर्निंग सर। सो लेट अस कमेंस टुडेज सेशन। यस्टरडेज क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट बेसिक नोटेशंस, especially the notations which are used in the modeling language specifically dedicated for the service oriented architecture. So we are streamlining the topics: service oriented analysis, service oriented design, service oriented modeling. All these three topics are streamlined in a single gauge. Okay, so yesterday we have seen three different sections of notations regarding connectivity, regarding individual functionalities, as well as we have seen the basic software engineering entities on coupling and cloning also. So these are all the things that we have seen yesterday in a detailed fashion, as well as we have seen some of the basic interconnections that have happened through our four basic models, okay, on connectivity. So generalization, specialization, expansion, etc. So today we are going to see the actual diagrams, right? So there are 9 diagrams in your UML, right? So likewise here, these are all the diagrams that you have to remember. How to draw these diagrams you must know, as well as if any use case scenario has been given, you try to interpret it whichever is necessary for the corresponding scenario you have to draw and submit, right? So that could be the case. So for drawing these diagrams, the notations that you have to incorporate what we have taught you yesterday, right? So that could be the idea behind this complete session. Okay, that's the case. Right, these are all the diagrams that you are going to learn: analysis proposition diagram, business integration diagram, logical relationship diagram, logical composition diagram, transaction diagram. Right, so they have given us examples, but you could be able to derive a lot from this. Okay, but as per your syllabus, I think I could be able to restrict up to this. That this would be more than enough for you, right? Make sure that in your final year project work documentation, instead of incorporating the old UML diagrams, try to incorporate these new phased SOAD diagrams, right? So that will be that will convey that trend that you are in line, right? So that could be the section from my side. Let us see one by one. Okay, so how to draw them. First one, analysis proposition diagram, right? I think here you could be able to identify the scenario in a easier way, right? You have to travel back to your third unit to understand the scenario. Here we are having a general service which is called reservation. Okay, we have a general service called reservation. That reservation is being customized for flight, hotel, right? So that could be clubbed with a general one called travel. Okay, that could be again customized for standard car and luxury car under our car reservation, right? So these type of things will ready to exhibit the scenario. Make sure that all the functional requirements, functional requirement 1, functional requirement 2. Likewise, if we list out all the functional requirements must be represented as atomic services. Okay, atomic services. Please remember that. Okay, so flight reservation is the atomic service. Hotel reservation is the atomic service. Car reservation is the atomic service. Again, in the standard car reservation is the atomic service. Luxury car reservation is the atomic service. So in this diagram, along with the general these functional requirements, they are incorporating event handling also, right? Event handling means one time booking or multiple times booking, that is being depicted through single event and recurring event. Okay, single event and recurring event. So through that they are representing the atomic services. Okay, first you have to identify, how to draw the diagram. I am conveying the methodology. From the functional requirements, filter out the functional requirements which can be represented as the atomic service. Those things are being drawn by using this diamond or rhombus that what they have given. Okay, next, the activity or the major label under the atomic services are going to be projected or given through these types of representation, right? Travel booking, that could be the root node of this complete section. Okay, in the travel booking, I am having car reservation and event booking. Please understand that travel booking is the major scenario here. So in that, I am ready to differentiate the event booking and car reservation. Even for travel booking, I could be able to incorporate boarding and lodging, or logistics and boarding. Likewise, I can create one more scenario for that. Within that scenario, I could be able to come for this flight reservation and hotel reservation, right? So that is also being possible. Okay, so that could be the case. Now try to understand the functionalities which can be ready to be clubbed. Okay, ready to be clubbed, that could be the case. Okay, so how they are clubbing? Standard car reservation and luxury car reservations will be under the module car reservation, right? That can be represented through the composite service representation. Okay, so that could be the major case that you need to know about that. Regarding aggregation also, right? So aggregation, so in travel booking, car reservation is one of the part, right? So that's what I am ready to aggregate those things over here. Okay, so that could be the case here. And see, regarding the term called subtraction, that what I am doing, I am omitting some of the features, right? But it is also will come under the section. That's what. So event booking, right? That event booking could not be accommodated into the main module, because this is the one which will do services on all these three things: flight, hotel, car, right? So this could be the this major event handling trigger could be the one that will be employed in all these three things. That is the reason why I am subtracting this from the existing atomic services, right? So to differentiate them. Okay, that means one more case that we could be able to talk about here. What is that actually? The flight reservation, hotel reservation, car reservation are completely based upon collecting data from the customer. Collecting data from the customer, the process of allocation will be done through event booking. Okay, so once event booking is completed, I am going to supply them a single ID, right? Regarding their flight means PNR, hotel means the reservation ID, car means that I am going to supply that car vehicle number and the corresponding trip number. That's all. These are the things that I am going to supply. Okay, so in those case, the process of representing the composite services are mandatory, right? So please understand that the process of representing the composite services are mandatory, right? So analysis proportion diagram, what you have to do and how you have to draw. First, point one, you have to list the available atomic services in the scenario, right? Next, you have to identify the composite services available in the given scenario. Next, third one, what are all the atomic services that can be subtracted from the main set of services, right? Here we have subtracted even booking. Okay, so likewise you have to filter it up. In the sub steps, what I have to do, I have to identify the composite services exist in the available atomic services. Okay, so step 2 will be void if I could not able to find direct composite service, right? Direct composite service. So ultimately here composite services are being available for the existing atomic services, right? That could be the major case under representation, right? So regarding representation, so you have to combine with here, right? So remember the major case. See, the normal representation will be on par with that. So there would be a plus encircled, right? That is the first notation you could able to see here. Second notation, there is a minus encircled with, right? Two triangles are clubbed to represent the corresponding composition, right? So expansion is being mentioned through the double headed entity, that nothing but that I could able to convey it as a coupling. Okay, so that is also being given over on that. So these notations are important that when you are going to draw the corresponding diagram. So how can I choose the notations? That is the reason why first you have to list the things that whatever I have conveyed, right? Probably the steps whatever I have conveyed that are applicable for the diagrams, that what we are going to see in the later cases also, right? So that could be the complete case that I am going to move with. Okay, so that's the complete idea on this. Okay, so by considering this analysis proposition diagram, we have learned the procedure. First one, list the atomic services. Second one, list the composite services. And the third one, identify the composite services that can be that are available in the existing atomic services, right? So that could be the major three steps. In the sub step, that you have to identify the process that are necessary, the generalized process that are necessary for managing these services. Example, the basic notes, notations that what we have seen, right? After that, where we have to apply these notations, follow the steps already I have conveyed you, right? So that could be the cases where I have to do subtraction, where I have to do expansion, right? Where I have to represent my composite service, those notations must be used, right? So that could be the case that on this analysis proposition diagram. Next, business integration diagram, right? Nothing but the logic. Okay, how I am going to club my logic? That could be the case that we are ready to represent, right? Here I am ready to incorporate you some more notations on this. Okay, so integration is going to be mentioned by the projection symbol, right? Integration is going to be mentioned by the projection symbol. Okay, that might be see here this projection symbol. this is my projection symbol, right? Here also you could be able to see the projection symbol. Okay. Fine. And here I have a projection symbol. See that the place where I am clubbing my service with the logic. Okay, that means if you want to say very clearly, that is the place that I am accessing the service from external. If you want to say very clearly, a URL which is ready to access the service, right? As per our RESTful web service, that could be the case. Okay, so in the same business case scenario only, how could I able to incorporate this? So here I have to represent my domains. In business integration diagram, I have to represent my domains. That could be the case. Like our three-tier approach or two-tier approach, it's not mandatory, but you can mention. Okay, so what is that business tier and the leisure tier that they have mentioned? It is a notation that what you will follow in your corresponding activity diagram that you will come to know about that. Right? So the same thing has been used over here. So that means that is the place where my transition will stop. That's all, not more than that. These two things are that you could be able to represent or it is not necessary. It's up to your case. But the thing is, these are all mandatory here. Okay. So these domains, identify the domains, business domain, services domain in terms of travel, right? So next, travel booking domain, event bookings domain. See, when you are going to issue these many number of domains, you must have the available number of atomic services and the composite services for this domain. So please remember that. Okay, atomic services and composite services are mandatory. That is the reason why that you are ready to capture these domains here. So at what point the corresponding events are need to be clubbed, right? At the what point the corresponding logics are need to be called. So that could be the case that you have to represent here. Okay, so here you could be able to see event booking, travel booking, rental booking. Okay, event booking, travel booking, rental booking, that has been given over there. So here and again I'll be conveying that rental booking has been introduced here additionally. Okay, rental booking has been introduced here additionally. So business event booking and travel booking only we have seen in the previous section. Okay, business event booking and travel booking. In this, I think they have omitted the flight reservation. They have incorporated car and hotel reservation. So here, the event booking is going to be clubbed with the travel booking. So remember the notation that what we are ready to use here. Okay, so event booking is being clubbed with the travel booking. Do we have any relationship with that? That is the reason why all these things are being combined into the single cluster. Okay, business domain, events booking and travel booking, all these things are combined into the single domain. Okay, and if you come across that travel and rental are being combined into the single cluster, right? So these things will convey us what are all the possibilities where we can club or where we can cluster the respective set of logics. The reason I'll tell you, because accessing the server workspace should not be redundant always, right? If every get and post will incur you a cost. Every get and post, I think you know about get and post. So get and post are the corresponding request and reply for the web services. Every get and post will ready to cost me. In case if it is going to be integrated, best you can deploy a Docker format, right? That means installing the complete bundle in a server, create a Docker, supply the Docker credentials or you could be able to replicate Dockers for the individual user instances, that would be more than enough, right? So to represent all those things only, the integration could be clubbed in here. So that is the major thing that being represented through this diagram, right? See, and also here you have to note your point here. So business service cluster, they are introducing this here, business service cluster. So in the business service cluster, what are all the things that you could able to integrate, that you could able to identify from the scenario, right? See, this is completely user friendly. You can introduce your own clusters in that, no issues. But how you are going to identify the atomic services available, how you are going to identify the composite services available. So that is the only thing that you have to take care of. Okay, so that could be the thing that are completely rely upon. Okay. Right. The next case, service oriented logical design relationship diagram. Okay, service oriented logical design relationship diagram. Why it has been introduced? Because we don't have the feature of asynchronous flow in normal modeling notations, but here asynchronous notations are being mentioned. That is the major case, right? So all the services are available in my service bus, ESB. Already I have shown you, right? Enterprise service bus during our closing of our units. ESB, enterprise service bus. So that service bus is having our major composite, atomic services, flight reservation, hotel reservation, and a car reservation. So service bus will try to incorporate these three reservations. Okay, service bus will try to incorporate these three reservations. And how to coordinate all those things, ESBs will take care, right? Enterprise service bus will ready to take care. See, for example, even when you can check with your Amazon, you could able to come across a feature. You are ordering three items in the single shopping cart. Okay, three items in the single shopping cart. Unfortunately, two items will be delivered from Amazon facility. One item will be delivered from the some XYZ Marketing Private Limited from there. So in those case, tracking ID would be different. Okay, first point. Second thing, dispatch and delivery, right? That could be entirely different compared to the things which are being delivered from Amazon facility and from XYZ Marketing, right? So in those case, how I could able to club it, right? So what could be the one, right? If items are available, then no issues. How could I able to deliver all those things at a time, right? Instead of varying the in very different dates of dispatching, how could I able to club it? And also make sure that there you have a constraint that you should not maintain or what you call, you should not delay anything. Already if it was being reached the environment, that you have to send it, right? That you have to send it. That could be the major one that you have to remember. So this is the issue which is happening really nowadays. Even you could be able to observe in e-commerce platforms. So how can we solve this? That could be the case. So ESBs will play a vital role. See, product 1, product 2, product 3. For P1, P2, P3, even though if I'm having two different tracking IDs or three different tracking IDs, it need to be delivered to the customer at a time, right? We should not say ultimately the invention of all these technologies and other things is nothing but how good our business can be improved. How our business can be improved? If we are going to keep our customer happy, ultimately business will get to be improved, right? Because I could not able to go and knock the door of my customer in a time, assume that the particular delivery partner is delivering morning one parcel, afternoon one parcel, evening one parcel. No, that could not be the right way to keep the people happy. They will get irritated, right? Why don't they supply at a time, right? So how could I able to do that, right? So assume that. So the service delivery is going to be delayed. In that case, even though if you are not going to pack in the individual, in a complete section into a single one, even though if you are packed differently, that it can be aligned in the service dispatch section. Okay, so it is it could be an introduced propagation delay to reach those places, right? That can be specified in the automation of this environment. That's what I'm trying to convey here. Okay, that could be the case. If the particular date flight reservation is available but car reservation is not available, or hotel reservation is not available, so how could I able to give a complete set? Even nowadays only, even in IRCTC, that they are trying to project us. I think you could able to see, for the past 1 year only, they are ready to 2 years only, they are ready to project the confirmation probability of the corresponding seat, right? So that is also from the being introduced as a service oriented logical design over here, right? So is it possible for me to supply a date where all these reservations are available? Or if for the particular flight reservation, if my favorite residency or hotel reservation is not available, shall I opt for the next set of reservation? Do I have that facility, right? So that is the reason why they are going for the customer profile and how good the customer is being, like how they are calculating the CIBIL score for making a loan EMI. But likewise, the customer profile also plays a vital role regarding customer credit. Okay, so that is also the places that where we have to think it over here, right? So that's the major point where I could able to club my services. That's the point of logical relationship. So you have to identify, that's the place, right? So how it can be combined, maybe compared to your these diagrams, right? So this is the place only we are performing analysis, right? What could be the major composition that we are ready to think it here? So here the places where we are interfacing the business logic with the service environment, right? So here only actually we are working with our service oriented computing. Yeah. Computing, I'm not using the term architecture, computing. Okay, so in the basis of availability, that are you going to give the results, or in the basis of non-availability that you are going to give results. See, instead of showing messages on this date, these things are not available, like instead of that, what you can convey in this date, things are available, right? That you could be able to convey. Even business and premium customers will be expecting that. Okay, so that could be the thing. That means while you are going to represent your logical design relationship, consuming a way that logics also being retrieved from the understanding. Okay? So that could be the major one. Being represented through this logical design relationship diagram. Next, the order. Okay, this is also a notation. The order. Order means in which order that it will be executed. Do I have any intermediate representation for this? So all those things are being provided over here, right? I think you could be able to see here. Even booking is ready to delegate the request from the consumer, right? So for the service, so even reservation, that they are ready to go over for that. So in that, booking registration and booking confirmation, how they are going to carry out, right? So see that representation. We have a lot of things that I could be able to take it for that unidirectional characters. So reservation client will receive the confirmation. That is the reason why double-headed arrow is being projected over there, right? So even booking is ready to reply with a ID. Okay, so your reservation ID. That's what. So even booking, even reservation, even booking confirmation. Okay, so all those things are being represented here. And one more thing, reservation client, this is the view of reservation client. Okay, how can you create the view for the other stakeholders? Okay, how can you create the view for the other stakeholders? For example, they have taken here even booking alone, right? So for example, hotel reservation, okay, car reservation, flight reservation. So for those things also, you try to replicate this use. So the reservation client, how this booking, reservation, booking confirmation, how they are going to represent. Okay, so and you have to identify that the cycle is formed here. Even booking, even reservation, booking confirmation, booking registration, right? All those things are being combined here. So the entire process is represented here in terms of a composite service. That's what they want to represent here. So likewise, what are all the individual services which are available over here that you have to identify it? That means very internal depleted regions. That how could you be able to identify on the particular logic, right? For example, in reservation cancellation, okay, the reserved tickets are going to be cancelled. So in those case, PNR ID will be supplied, ticket data are fetched, ask the confirmation from the passenger. If the passenger supplied, if the passenger have given confirmation, go for the cancellation process. Once the cancellation process is completed, deliver the cancellation slip to the passenger. Second thing, you have to make request to the bank to debit this much amount of rupees for the corresponding PNR. Okay, so this much amount of rupees for the corresponding PNR. So for bank, there is no need of PNR, right? So this much amount of money has to be returned to this particular account number to be credited. This is the instruction given to the bank. Second thing, for the corresponding vendor, this is the percentage to be retained. Okay, that is also being mentioned. Okay, that is the thing, or that is the place where they will keep out their voucher. So the operator, the reservation operator, the bus or flight or train, whatever may be, they will keep some percentage and the remaining only they will give over, hand over towards the passenger. So in those case, that is also an internal calculation will happen. What is the calculation? This is the total fare, right? Next, in this total fare, this is the percentage of calculation for this many number of hours. Okay, so after that, I have to perform a subtraction. After performing subtraction, subtracted component will be credited back to the reservation client. The result will be credited back to the customer's account. That's all, right? This could be the internal logic that you could be able to represent through this logical design composition diagram. Okay, so that is the idea on this. Okay, so this is the way how we what do you call it? This could be a model, star design. Okay. So how my any centralized services are available, how it can be represented. So this could be like a star representation. Okay. So I think wherever that we are going for any centralized services, it can be used. So in this use case scenario, for customer support environment, they have used this. So what are all the things that, see, again, I'll be telling you, so you could be able to club here. You could be able to club here. Because in star, they have identified as four nodes here. First node is completely talking about booking. Second node is completely talking about client profile. Third node is completely talking about surveys and service. Okay. And the fifth one is talking about the references. Okay. So that could be the thing. So likewise, you could be able to cluster those things for each and every node of the star. Okay. So that means identify that in a use case or in a scenario, if you are having anything called centralized services, that you could be able to do. Okay. Here they have created the centralized services for the whole travel and booking. That's what they have mentioned here. Okay. So that means travel and the event booking means for all logistics, boarding, as well as business event registration. For all these three things that they have given this customer support. So representation, they have given multiple, right? Many, that's the reason why it is being represented that all are being available overall. Right? I think probably I will stop here. I think this could be the overdose today. If you have any clarifications, you can ask. We'll continue from the next session.